we'll be comparing today the Chinese Index 12 injectors versus the OEM, brand new from the dealer, Index 12s. So the first thing that stands out is the serial numbers on all of these is the exact same. The actual writing looks like it's brand new. Doesn't look like it was scratched off or anything, but I have a feeling these are getting washed off with some solvent or something, and then they're re-laser printing these inscriptions. I decided I'm not even gonna try these because I don't trust them. And the injectors actually also show signs of usage, as you can see on the connector. So, and they smell like fuel, so they must have been ran before, and these are just old injectors. They're rebranding, so make sure you guys don't get scammed. Now, looking at the OEM injectors, you can see the serial numbers or the coding numbers, they're all different from each other, and this logo and everything looks a little bit more faint than the Chinese injectors. Like, see how crisp this is? Just making sure you guys don't get scammed, because there's a lot of Index 12s for sale used, and this could be one of these Chinese ones. So just double check, but we're gonna throw these in to our N54 135i. All right, guys, first we're gonna take these fuel lines off. These nuts on the fuel lines are 14 millimeters, so you can just use an open-ended wrench for those. We already went ahead and drained the fuel pressure on all these injectors, so we should get minimal fuel leaking out once we loosen them up.
Hold me close till I get up. Time is barely on our side. I don't wanna waste what's left. The storms we chase are leading us, and love is all we'll ever try.
So now that we have all of these fuel lines off, we can go ahead and get these connectors off. Alright, next step will be to use the special tool to pull the injectors out, but first we have to loosen that right there. These little plates is what's holding the injectors in place. So we're gonna loosen those. Here has a slight bend to it, so the bolt will go on top of here like this. Alright, so now we're gonna use this pull out tool that we got from Amazon. I think they're like 50 bucks, but I'll put a link in the description. And you basically just yank it and it comes out. Then you loosen this. This is a threaded part that goes onto the injector. And there's one.
Through the wastelands, through the highways, and on we'll go.
This car had a lot of residual oil in the cylinders from the old valve cover. So we now have cleaned as much as possible, but I'll do some more cleaning. I want to make sure that where the injectors actually sit, there's not a single drop of oil down there. All right, now that this is all cleaned up, use some brake cleaner to clean the rest of the oil off of here. Now, these are the old injectors, So this is cylinder one, this is cylinder six. Cylinder four looks like a 12, probably has been replaced before, but the seal is not there. Might have been why we had an issue. Double check, make sure it didn't stay in the bore. But yeah, all these seals are going to be put new on the new injectors. This is the seal guide tool, and it also comes with the new clips from the dealer. So we'll get those assembled shortly and then drop up these new ones. The main thing I can see on these injectors is the residual oil that we had from the old valve cover. But yeah, these are all, well, shit, we have a 7, 12, 9, so these are all random, which made sense why the car might have ran weird. But we'll test it out once we put the new ones and see how she runs. One important detail that I want to note before we put these in, I'm going to take a picture of this. And this is going to be cylinder 1, this is going to be cylinder 6, so we can see all the coding numbers because we're going to need those later. Alright, so actually what I noticed when I took the caps off, the OEM injectors, they came with the little gasket right there, the plastic O-ring that we're supposed to install, but we did get an extra just in case. But we won't be using the plastic clips, we'll just use the mounting hardware, and pretty much these are ready to go. So these clips, you actually have to install them like this onto the injector. There you go.
Have a bit of fun till I downfall, my love. If you feel like I do right now, don't say you're on the run to the other side, my love.
This lock is gonna lock in the middle of the lock down. To the car, we'll be using an Android tablet with Pro Tool and an MHD interface. So that's the connector we're using right there, the Bluetooth or Wi-Fi connector. So we're gonna hit connect. It should automatically get the VIN number and all that information and the chassis selection. So now that we're connected, we're gonna go to engine, and then we're gonna go functions, and then we're gonna go to injector coding. So each of these values is the numbers that we took pictures of in the earlier steps. So here you see injector 1 and injector 6. So basically these are the numbers right here that we will be putting in for each injector. So we start with 1. So now our coding is complete. We can exit out, cycle the ignition. All right. Still sounds like it has a misfire. So let's find out where. Cylinder 6 and cylinder 4. Oh, there we go. Might have been the residual fuel that was in there. Let's clear the errors and see if they come back. All right, yeah, it looks like it's idling perfectly fine now. Ready to go. And that's how you do your injectors on the N54. All right, guys, thank you for watching. And this was an overview on how to do these injectors. Again, very simple. This was my first time touching these injectors, and it was very easy. The only thing is I now have to replace this piece because I broke it taking it off, but it looked like it needed to be replaced anyway. So I'm gonna order a new valve that goes right there. And then this thing will be back on the road. We got a new windshield today, as you can see with the tape. Should be able to drive this thing in about 48 hours once everything cures and it's good to go.